The WASH program covers over 19 primary schools where students learn how to make sanitary pads as a way of helping them maintain menstrual hygiene.
We appreciate this organization for the extra mile that is taking us to another level, because they are doing much work in what we call WASH, water and sanitation and hygiene. Water is life. Hygiene is directly putting money in our pockets. Because instead of people going to the hospitals, they will be saving this money. Instead of drinking dirty water, they will be drinking safe water. And as we know, as the old slogan goes, water is life.
Hygiene management materials, the pad. The parents are not providing the pad, citing that they're expensive, provide pads to the girls, looking at these other manufactured pads disposable in the shops. Some parents think, because of the attitude, they think it's not ideal that they should buy those pads. So the children are just left there with no option other than, as adolescents, at times missing school when they are in their period. And we know what it means. Once they miss school, the other pupils will remain studying and they will not perform well. So to counter this, we have engaged in sensitizing parents, those who can afford, they need to buy pads for the children. But then where they say that they cannot afford the disposable pad per month, that's why we have come in to fill the gap by training the pupils in making reusable pads.
Asimwe Josephine, the deputy head teacher at Kakinga Primary School, says some students drop out of schools due to the poor learning environment. She noted that in some schools, students share latrines with teachers and some lack sanitary pads.
Very many challenges, by the way, because at our school the enrollment of girls is higher than that one of boys. But we had issues where we could find it. You go to P5, you find 6 girl children are absent. You go to P5, you find, you go to P3. So the children had a challenge, their parents being poor, parents could not afford to buy these the disposable pads. And when they could use the disposable ones from their that environment, they could not afford to sustain them for a whole day.
In an effort to curb the challenges, the Minister of Education and Sports, in partnership with Water for People, have embarked on construction of a latrine incinerator, extending water to the most affected primary schools under the WASH program to enable learners complete their education.
Working closely with Kamwenge District Local Government, Luka District Local Government, and other local governments, of course, under the leadership of the Ministry of Education and Sports, to support school WASH in schools, ensuring that we contribute to government efforts of attaining the 1-to-40 stance ratio. Of course, when we carry out assessments, we still see a great need. The children are many, and the facilities are few, or the toilet facilities, so to say, are few. So we complement the efforts of government to construct toilets and see that we move closer to the 1-to-40 ratio. We are not yet there, but it's a better picture. So every year...
As a way of widening coverage of sanitation, the ministry and the organization organized school WASH competitions, which involve music, dance and drama. And these competitions were won by St. Paul Primary School. And this was awarded a HEIFA, and the rest of the schools received music equipment. Report compiled by Anthony Atwine for the news.